हेलो एंड वेलकम टू द वर्ल्ड ऑफ स्मार्ट स्टडी एट द रेट ऑफ यूपीएससी। आई एम आशीष रंजन एंड आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू टॉपिक टुडे दैट इज रिलेटेड विथ द प्रीवियस टॉपिक। आई होप दिस टॉपिक विच आई एम गोइंग टू लीड नाउ विल लुक वेरी सिंपल एज द प्रीवियस वन। ओके एंड आई एम ट्राइंग टू resolve each query and problems that are coming to me and our team are really more than happy to assist all of you. Okay students, so let's come to the new topic. Okay, so our new topic today is that is Council of Ministers. I hope many of you have got many of the things about ministers because already you know about the facts related to the prime ministers and president. So this topic is coordinate between PM and president. Okay, it's a coordination between PM and president. Whatever the mandate given to the MPs of India in the general election, that mandate leads to the formation of prime minister of India appointed by the president of India. Fine. So let's come to the next slide, okay, in which we will reconsider the deep things that should be known to all of you. See, aid and advice. During the lectures, I mean the previous lectures, I have told you about whatever the aid and advice given by the prime minister to the president has to obligable to accept that aid and advice. I hope my language is so simple that all of you get it. Even if you are a Hindi medium students, you will get it. See students, few queries were about that, sir, please took some sessions in Hindi too. See students, I am not going to motivate any of you, but please look the past year results that are coming. Have you analyzed that past year results almost negligible in the topmost rankers with Hindi secured rankers? Have you got analyzed the past year results? I am not demotivating at all to any of you, but I am just trying to say that even if you are a Hindi medium students, just be confident in yourself. You will be achieve your target, but try to adopt in some English language too. That's why I keep my language so simple that even each and everyone can get my the understanding what I want to say you. Okay, if the some keywords that you know got in Hindi English language, so I will cover in Hindi when you ask the query. Okay, our team is assisting you in Hindi too, so please adopt yourselves. Even if you are a Hindi medium students, then please adopt. This is my humble request to please adopt yourself in English too. That is going to really beneficial for you because you are going to serve the nation after achieving your target, and at that position you have to become a personality like which can handle any kind of situation. Okay, so see students, add an advice. Before 1976, it was not clear that the aid and advice given by the prime ministers, okay, which was bounding on president, it was not clear at all before 1976. See, I have already told you in the last lecture that here is the prime minister, here is the prime minister, it is the nucleus of the power. Prime minister is the nucleus of the power, the real head of the state, head of the government, and surrounding to him there is a council of ministers. Council of Ministers. Okay, I hope all of you get it. Are you getting it or not? That Prime Minister is the nucleus power of the real head of the state, and the surrounding portions of Prime Ministers that forms a Council of Ministers. Okay, so these Council of Ministers, these are the ministers which are inside this councils known as Council of Ministers. So whatever the decisions वॉट एवर द एड एंड एडवाइसेज adopted by this council of ministers chaired by the prime minister. So ultimately it is the prime minister who will aid and advise the president. In another way we can also say that councils of ministers are advising to president of India. Okay, so either you pick up the point in this way or in that way, but the final conclusion is that Prime Minister or councils of ministers, because Prime Minister is also inside the Council of Minister. Okay, even if any captain leading the Indian cricket team, so he is also a captain, but he is also a player too. He is also a player too, na? So if Prime Minister is a minister that is heading the whole Council of Minister, she is also a minister. Actually, Prime Minister takes the oath in third schedule as a minister. Okay, after that, he adopts as Prime Minister. So, in a way, you can say that aid and advice given by the Prime Minister to the President is binding on the President. But on another way, even you can say that aid and advice given by the Council of Ministers, because this is the decision of Councils of Ministers, each and every decision taken by each and every aid and advice taken by the councils of minister, that will be binding on the president. Binding means students, that whatever I am going to tell you, you have to accept. Okay, whatever I am going to tell you, you have to accept. You didn't have any other choice. That I accept, no, I am not accepting it, no, here is no choice. If there is any kind of aid and advice given by Council of Ministers, even Prime Minister is inside the Council of Ministers. So, if any advice given to the President, President have to accept it. Okay. So, all of you get it in two lines. Since Prime Minister is inside the Council of Ministers, so the decisions, the aid and advices given by the Prime Ministers is bounding on the President. And in the same way, since Prime Minister is inside the Council of Ministers, so the aid and advice given by the Council of Ministers chaired by the Prime Minister will be bounding on the President. That aid and advice will be bounded on the President. Okay, fine. I have given the first sentence in this lecture that earlier, before 1976, it was not clear that either the aid and advice given by the councils of ministers is binding on the president or not binding on the president. It was not clearly mentioned. Okay. But by 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act, please attentive. Okay, focus here. By 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act 1976, it has been mentioned in the constitution that now the aid and advice given by the councils of minister or even prime minister will be bounding on President of India. Just after 2 years, in 1978, when somebody fought, see, 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act is itself called a mini constitution. 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act was itself a mini constitution. It is called a mini constitution of India too, because it turned as one constitutional amendment act. 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act is only one amendment act, but it is itself a large elephant size in itself, that we call it as what? Mini Constitution of India. So whatever the amendments have been done in 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act 1976, after the government, the party of the ruling party changed in 1978, led by Mr. Morarji Desai, our former Prime Minister, he has changed some amendments that has been adopted in Morarji Desai, brought some kind of changes and amendments which has been changed in 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act. So actually Morarji Desai gets a chance to revoke the whole things, that no, it is not been clearly said that aid and advice will be bounding on the president. But at that time too, Morarji Desai have not correct it, or either we can say that not changed it. Either that was correction or not correction, it was upon a debate of matter for all the time. But since the current situation is that these aid and advices are bounding on the president. So even if you are asking a question that said by which act or by which procedure we can say that this aid and advice is bounding on the president. So it was 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act 1976. Due to this act, due to some amendments in this act, now the aid and advice is given by the councils of minister or even the prime minister, because prime minister chaired the council of minister, he is the head of the council of minister. So the present situation is that whatever the aid and advice is given by the councils of minister or even the by the prime minister will be bounded on the president. Fine. So move to the next slide, please. I hope what I am telling you, you will not get deflected from what I am saying right now. Okay, please don't deflect yourself. Otherwise, deflection will happen. Your concentration will be destroyed totally. Okay. Because of online classes, you have the chance to relook the whole things. Otherwise, in offline classes, this is not possible. You have to go to the faculty members and ask that thing again. Even few students really shy about asking that. So here is a real chance to see the real look of whole lectures. But remember, always try, whenever you see the online lectures, please don't make a mind, don't make mindset of that quality that look, if I will not get in that session, I can relook at after few times, few minutes, few hours, after few days. Please don't make your mind at that kind of quality. Always keep a mindset that this is the first time I am seeing and this will be the last one. Okay, in reality that is not happened, but you should do like that. That is why your concentration will appear in a very complex, in a very dynamic way. See, types of ministers. Here, see, you always hear that some state ministers, some independent charge ministers, some cabinet ministers. So what are these kind of ministers? I will take a separate session because these are the important ones, types of ministers. This can't be covered fully in this session, because I have to cover Council of Ministers as a whole. So the types of ministers I will cover in a separate session with a very large examples. Okay, I will take a separate session on that. But up overlook we have to give up to all of you. Okay, so let's move to the next slide. See, there are four types of ministers on an average. Mainly, we can divide it. Okay. So, see. Just see it. Here is Prime Minister. Have you got it? Not sitting Prime Minister, but I am just indicating. Here is Prime Minister of India. Just surrounding him. Actually, I am not able to mark the hole in a circular way, but please forgive me for that one. There is a cabinet ministers. Okay, here is Prime Minister, surrounding to him there is cabinet ministers. These are actually the most senior most minister. Okay, the most eligible ministers are called cabinet ministers. These are the strongest. These cabinet ministers are the strongest ministers just after the prime ministers. Okay, these ministers, which is called cabinet ministers, these are the closest one to the Prime Minister of India. These ministers directly inform the situation to the Prime Minister of India. That is why in India we can say that cabinet ministers are a huge power. Okay, cabinet ministers have a huge quality of power, as a huge kind of power. Okay, because they directly interact with Prime Minister in each and every session of meeting. Okay, almost every alternate, or we can say that whenever any kind of decision will be taken, cabinet minister will involve in that. ओके इन सर्टेन सर्टेन अस्कांसेज ओके इन सर्टेन एक्सेप्शनल सिचुएशंस डेट रिलेटेड विद सिक्योरिटी और समथिंग एल्स देन ओनली इट इज पॉसिबल डैट प्राइम मिनिस्टर एंड ओनली सम स्पेशल मिनिस्टर्स लाइक होम मिनिस्टर और डिफेंस मिनिस्टर्स अदरवाइज देर विल अ फुल कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स सराउंडेड टू द प्राइम मिनिस्टर अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट सराउंडिंग टू द कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स सराउंडिंग टू द कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर देर इज मिनिस्टर ऑफ अ स्टेट दैट इज इंडिपेंडेंट चार्ज MOS, Minister of a State, okay, Minister of a State, that is independent charge, remember the thing, Minister of a State are two types, but here the Minister of, Minister of a State, these are independent charge ministers, first of all, Prime Minister, nucleus one, the central nucleus power authority, after him, there is a cabinet ministers, the closest one to the Prime Ministers, the most strongest one just after prime minister surrounding to cabinet ministers there are a group of ministers in the council of ministers the whole circle is a council of ministers okay the whole circle is a council of ministers fine so inside that council of minister just surround to the cabinet ministers there are the ministers called as minister of a state of independent charge these ministers inform to the cabinet ministers whatever the situation present in the time in the area So, Minister of a State of Independent Charge, member, Minister of a State of Independent Charge will inform the Cabinet Minister. It is very rarely that Minister of a State of Independent Charge will directly contact to the Prime Minister. It is very rarely, okay. Just surrounding to Minister of a State of Independent Charge, here is Minister of a State, MOS, okay, MOS. So, what are the differences between them? A detailed session will be coming up after few times. I will provide so many examples in that session that you will easily differentiate between them. Because it will take almost 1 hour for understanding the whole differences between them. So, this is not the session of types of ministers. This is a session about Council of Ministers. How to understand the working behavior of councils of minister in India okay so here is prime minister just surrounding to prime minister there are cabinet minister just surrounding to cabinet minister there are minister of a state of independent charge which inform cabinet ministers and just surrounding to minister of a state of independent charge there are minister of a state one difference is that minister of a state of independent charge does not share any ministry in them If you are getting confusion in it, you will also get confusion in whole lectures today. That is why I am not dealing with the differences today. I am just giving an overview, okay, of councils of minister. Okay. So, minister of a state is somewhat a lower position than minister of a state of independent charge. After that, there are deputy ministers actually see deputy ministers are the junior ones we can say that they are in the training form okay they are in the training form okay that's why if the same party will come in the power again then it is possible that the deputy minister will further promote it in another ministers okay because cabinet minister is such a huge charge a that kind of position of office that a junior minister that have not worked earlier in those manners if they will not capable to perform the work for our nation that is why this kind of surroundings are made in the democratic country of our nation I think all of you have get it I already told you the differences that correlation with examples I will take in a detailed session, okay? Because if I will go through this in the same session, you will get confused in the upcoming slides, okay? So move to the next slide, please. I think I should erase this one, so it will be clearly visible to all of you. So, students, I am just taking as the simple language, so even each and every students can understand it properly. One important thing, even if you are covering 70 to 75% of my lectures, you will be definitely going to achieve your target. But please don't do like that. Okay, cover 100%, but if you are covered almost 70 to 75%, then I am making you sure here that you don't need any kind of extra materials, any other coachings, not anything else. Okay, I have the experience of this kind of quality teaching from since a while. Okay, fine. So now there is a responsibility. See, there are two kind of responsibility. One is collective, another one is individual. Fine. So what is the difference between them? I am just clarifying all your doubts right now. Responsibility means responsibility of councils of ministers, because this session is about councils of ministers. So the responsibility of councils of ministers is of two types. One is collective, another one is individual. See, if you will get both of these points, you will feel a really happy mood, a jolly mood in teaching purpose, because these are the conceptual ones. You can't remember these kind of keywords. See, please don't try to memorize that responsibility of council of ministers are divided in two parts. One is collective, one is individual. Don't remember like that. Even if you are forgetting this, you can provide separate word for collective, even provide individual a separate word. Okay, even if you are forgetting it, you can, if you are a smart guy, you can definitely, if you are a smart student, you can definitely reorganize the things in your own way. Okay, so please don't memorize that kind of quality which I am writing here. Okay, try to develop your own attention. Okay, see, what is collective responsibility of councils of ministers? Fine. See, just give 3 minutes more attention, your doubts will be clear. See, I have already told you there are a group of ministers surrounded by prime minister. Fine. So if anything happen inside the councils of ministers, then the whole council of ministers is responsible to the Lok Sabha. Definitely or not? In India, it is said that executive is responsible to legislature. Fine. What that mean? You will get slowly, slowly. I even don't need to tell you about this line. You will eventually get all these lines. Okay. If I am going to explain these lines, then you will forget what I have previously said. Just remember that executive is responsible to legislative, that is Lok Sabha, and even Rajya Sabha too. Okay, since parliament, it means parliament. So these are collective responsibility to the Lok Sabha. Fine. If any decision taken inside council of ministers, that is, for that decision, the whole council of ministers is responsible, not any individual. Fine. Have you heard any time that inside, whenever any cabinet meeting is going on, and after that cabinet meeting, any minister says, and in the media, and said that, or even in the press bureau, that I have given this decision, I have taken this decision? No, not at all. It is said that in this meeting, this decision has been taken by our prime minister, and all the ministers that are in the councils of ministers, that are in the cabinet ministers, are present in it, and this decision has been taken. Okay, so see, that is why it is collective responsibility. What is individual responsibility? See, think it is another way. What I have told you, suppose if government lose the majority, if government is not having 272 plus right now, after forming the government, it may possible that after some while, it is possible that the government has not majority of 272 plus because of some any kind of problem. Some MPs have defect. What is anti-defection law? I will take a separate session. That is too important, because that is happening so many times right now in our country that is a highlighted topic. So I will take a separate session on anti-defection law. So if government has no majority in Lok Sabha, then government will fall. Fall or not? It's fall, na? So whenever the government will fall down, pull down their leg, then it is not possible that only one minister from Council of Ministers will lose their position. Okay. So all the ministers that is inside the Council of Ministers, all will have to resign. If the government will collapse, all the Council of Ministers will be dissolved. Lok Sabha will be dissolved. So their collective responsibility, their responsible is collectiveness sense among them. Fine. In another sense, it is individual. Why and how? Just look. If any, see, this is PM and surrounding to him, these are the councils of ministers. Okay. So if suppose a minister that is named as A, if Prime Minister looking that this minister is not suitable for our councils of ministers due to any reason, even if possible that he may not like his work, the kind of behavior of working manner he is not liking it or anything, if his performance is not good, if prime minister wants that this minister should resign from his office or otherwise I will remove, then what PM will do? That PM will say to the president of India that look, please, Prime Minister will say to the president that please remove this minister from the Council of Ministers. So president will take the action. In that case, only this person, or it may possible that two persons together, three persons together, but it is possible that even one single minister can be removed from the office of councils of minister. It is possible, na? Are you getting it? So in one situation they are collectiveness sense, in another situation they are individual into. Are you getting it or not? I hope all of you are getting it. Okay, so in 1 minute I am recapping it. If government has collapsed, then the whole council of minister has to resign because the Lok Sabha will be dissolved. Fine. And even if certain decisions have been taken from the councils of ministers, then the whole councils of ministers is responsible for that decision. Okay. Fine. And executive, these are the part of executives. These councils of ministers are executive, not legislative. They are legislative too because they are from the parliament, but their mainly work is to executive. In India, there is no proper separation of executive and legislative. Fine, there is no proper separation. Even there is no proper separation from executive and judiciary, because ultimately judiciary is being somehow appointment, their salary and other things chosen by executive and legislative. So they are not properly separated from one each other, like America. In America, in USA, they are separated. They are properly separated. Okay. Proper separation of power in America between legislative, executive and judiciary. But in India, there is no proper separation of power between legislative, executive and judiciary. Fine. So if certain decisions have been taken, then the decisions will be responsible collectiveness by the council of ministers to the legislative. Legislative means parliament. I hope all of you get it or not. I hope so. If you are confused in it, try to develop a sense of asking the question from our team. They are helping you a lot. Okay. So moving to the next slide. What the next slide will tell you? That is appointment and oath of secrecy about councils of ministers. This is not a particular session of Prime Minister. Okay. This is not about particular session of Prime Minister. I have covered that in yesterday's lecture. But this is about councils of ministers, and even Prime Minister also comes under councils of ministers. So appointment has been done by whom? By President of India. Okay. So Prime Minister is appointed by प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया एंड इवन द काउंसिल्स ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स आर अपॉइंटेड बाय द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया. फाइन. सो प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया, आई एम जस्टिफाइजिंग इट, प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया टेक्स द ओथ अकॉर्डिंग टू आर्टिकल 60 ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया एंड दैट इज अ स्पेशल आर्टिकल ओनली फॉर प्रेसिडेंट्स ओथ. ओके. एंड ऑल द मिनिस्टर्स, इवन द प्राइम मिनिस्टर टेक्स ओथ अकॉर्डिंग टू शेड्यूल 3 of the Constitution of India. Schedule 3. According to Schedule 3 of the Constitution of India, Prime Minister takes their oath and all the ministers that are in the Council of Ministers takes the oath according to Schedule 3 of the Constitution of India. And they will take the oath of secrecy. Remember this fact, secrecy and allegiance too. They will all take oath of secrecy and allegiance too. Even the Prime Minister. Fine. So I'm moving to the next slide. That is about pleasure of the president. Okay, see, ministers inside the councils of ministers surviving in this ministry only till whenever the president fell, because that is why it is said that it councils of ministers survive on their location during the pleasure of president. Okay, pleasure of president means it is not the president who ever want and removed it from Council of Ministers, no. But pleasure of the president means ultimately Prime Minister will advise that this person should not be in the Council of Ministers, so please remove it. So president will remove it. So ultimately it is the president, he have to do on the advice of Prime Minister, at an advice of Prime Minister. But ultimately doing whom? Doing in the name of which personality? It is president. So it is the ultimately president who is removing in the final time this person from out of Council of Minister. That is why it is said that it is pleasure of the president. Okay, pleasure of the president means it is the pleasure of the president that whomever he wants to remove from the office, he can remove. He can remove, but only on the aid and advice of Prime Minister. Second thing is that it is 15% means what? See, how many ministers can be formed in any party? A fixed number. Earlier it was not fixed. That is why a council of ministers are look so budgy and so bulky that executive is somehow going to be overlapping the legislative and becoming more and more powerful than legislative. That's why by 91st Constitutional Amendment Act, okay, it is done that now any party which is the ruling party which has in the form of government cannot include number of ministers, cannot include more than 50%, more than 15%. If there are, suppose there are 500 MPs in Lok Sabha, 15% of what? 15% of not their means winning seats. If out of 500 MPs, suppose anyone who is ruling the government has 260 seats, okay, because 250 not a majority mark. So if he has 260, okay, I am making it more visible. If it is 260 marks, 500 total MPs in Lok Sabha, suppose, okay, it's 545, sorry, it's 543. So if it is 260, the party has, which is the ruling party right now, so not 15% of 260, okay, it's 15% of what? A strength of power of the house, a strength of the house, a strength of the membership of the house. So you can't make ministers more than 15% of 500, okay. So you can't move more than 75 persons as minister. You can't make, Prime Minister of India can't make more than 75 MPs as ministers, maximum 75, whenever there was 500 MPs, but he can make more because there is 543, okay, so he can even more make. Earlier it was not fixed, so it was so bulky Council of Ministers that here it is 500 MPs and there are ministers are 150, 200, so they will strengthen their power over legislative. There is 6 months. Anyone can become a minister in the same way as Prime Minister. See, I have taken that session in Prime Minister and clearly explained it, just revising it with the same of ministers. So anyone can become minister even if he is not a member of parliament. Anyone can become a member of parliament even if he or she is not a member of parliament right now. Anyone can become minister if he or she is not at present time a member of parliament. He or she can become minister too. But after become a ministry, after administrating the ministry, okay, handling the office of charge, he have to be a member of parliament within 6 months. He or she have to be a member of, or he or she be to member of, to be a member of either of the house, either Lok Sabha or Raj Sabha. The same condition for Prime Minister too. Have you got it? So I hope this is clear to all of you. If any other slide remaining, I will cover. No. So the session is over and we are going to solve the questions of the previous class. That is, that class was about Prime Ministers. So I have given almost 4 to 5 questions on the basis of chapter of Prime Ministers. So the whole things may be revisable. Okay. So I am just solving those questions. So the first question is, who is termed as primus inter pares? Primus inter pares means? Primus inter pares. It means students, first among equals. Primus inter pares means, primus inter pares means first among equals. What it means? It means in the whole council of ministers, okay, equals means councils of ministers, among equals means councils of ministers here. So in the whole councils of ministers, in the whole ministry, Prime Minister is the head one. Prime Minister is the leading personality. That is why he is the first among equals. Among equals means councils of ministers, and Prime Minister is first. So Prime Minister is the first among councils of ministers, and for that a special keyword, that is primus inter pares. So Prime Minister is the primus inter pares. So option B is the correct answer. Fine. Now second question, please. Here question number 2 is, which is correct? There are two statements given and the question is asking that which statement is correct, either one or two or both of them or none of the above. Okay, fine. So which is correct? The first one statement is, the constitution, listen carefully and see here, the constitution does not contain, the constitution does not contain, does not specify, okay, does not have provision anything. So the constitution does not contain any specific, see, any procedure, not any specific procedure for the selection and appointment of the PM. Have you got it? This is right or not? That the constitution does not have any kind of provision for a specific procedure for the selection and appointment of the PM. There is no specific provision available in the constitution. I have told you already in the last session. Remember that. Okay. Only it was mentioned that president will appoint the Prime Minister. Only this thing mentioned in the Constitution of India. Okay. Nowhere in the Constitution of India it is mentioned that what is the procedure for the selection of Prime Minister and what is the procedure for appointment of the Prime Ministers. How, why, if you are forgetting it, just see my previous lecture of Prime Minister. So this statement is correct. Second statement is, the Constitution does not require that a person must prove his majority in Lok Sabha before he is appointed as the PM. I have already told you in the previous session that if a person A is becoming Prime Minister of India, okay, then before becoming Prime Minister, he doesn't need to prove his majority, that look, I have the majority, okay, I can prove right now. It doesn't need. If President feels you have the majority, okay, and you are making sure to the President that, see, these are my seats and I will definitely form the government. So President will appoint him as the Prime Minister, and during appointment, it doesn't need that this person, the candidate of prime minister has to prove his majority at the same time. No. Time was given to for that kind of work for that is 1 month. Okay. 1 month has been given. Within 1 month, he has to prove his majority. Okay. So, the constitution does not require that a person must prove his majority in Lok Sabha before he is appointed as the PM. So, this statement is also correct. Nowhere in the constitution of India it is mentioned that please prove the majority before you are appointed as a prime minister. Nowhere mentioned. It is time given minimum 1 month or maximum 1 month, minimum to maximum, whatever you can say. So, 1 month time has been given. Within 1 month, you have to prove your majority. Okay. So, moving to the next question. Next question says that Prime Minister will take the oath of, even this question looks so simple because I have given this answer in today's session. Okay. But I hope all of you have solved this problem yesterday. So, Prime Minister will take the oath of either Defender of the Constitution. Defender of the Constitution is who? It is Chief Justice of India or President or Vice President or Prime Minister. It is President of India. President of India takes the oath that I will protect, preserve and defend the Constitution of India. Remember the facts. President of India takes the oath as I will protect, preserve and defend the Constitution of India. That comes under Article 60. Okay. So, it is President. Custodian of the Constitution, is it President or Vice President? No, it's JJI, Chief Justice of India. Fine. Chief Justice of India is the custodian of the Constitution of India. This question has already come in the UPSC in, I think, 2014-15 or somewhat is 16. So, between mid-2015, this question has been asked that who is the custodian of Constitution of India? Okay. So, it is Supreme Chief Justice of India. It is means Supreme Court. Supreme Court of India. Okay. Supreme Court of India. So, oath of secrecy. Yeah, this is right. I have also taken that Prime Minister and even all the ministers take the oath of secrecy according to oath of secrecy as well as oath of allegiance. Okay. According to Schedule 3, President takes the oath according to Article 60 and Prime Minister and even all the ministers take the oath according to Schedule 3 of the Constitution of India. So, this answer is correct, option C. So, I hope I should move to the next question right now. Please move. Next one is said, aid and advice of PM over President is aid and advice given by Prime Minister to the President is either binding or not binding or it's depending upon a time to time, situation to situation, is it? No, this is totally incorrect. So, now if you are confusing in that, I hope no confusion in it because I have repeated it so many times. So, it is binding. Binding by which amendment act? Before 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act 1976, it was not clear that either it is binding or not. Okay. But by 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act 1976, now it is proved that it is binding on the President. Okay, binding on the President. The aid and advice given by the Prime Minister or even by the councils of minister to the President is binding on the President of India. So, this question also gettable. Now, move to the last one, that is fifth one. Chairman of Niti Aayog is, earlier it was Planning Commission, but now it is Niti Aayog. I will take also separate session on Planning Commission and Niti Aayog. But that one is economics. But a Niti Aayog chapter, I should try to cover in polity too. So, chairman of Niti Aayog is whom? Either it's Prime Minister, President, Governor of RBI, because he regulates the monetary policy of India, and either Finance Ministry, who looks fiscal policy. This what is monetary fiscal policy? These are the tools, okay, of conducting the economy of India. This will be taken in economic session. Okay. So, chairman of Niti Aayog is Prime Minister. Prime Minister lead the chairmanship of Niti Aayog. So, I hope all the queries have been resolved. So, if any are the questions or slides remaining, no students. So, see, आई हैव कवर्ड यस्टरडे प्राइम मिनिस्टर, राइट नाउ आई हैव कवर्ड अबाउट काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स लीड बाय होम प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया. प्राइम मिनिस्टर इज द प्राइमस इंटर पेरेस, दैट इज फर्स्ट अमॉन्ग इक्वल्स, फर्स्ट अमॉन्ग ऑल द काउंसिल्स ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स. ही इज द फर्स्ट वन, ही इज द लीडिंग वन. सो आई होप दिस सेशन हैज बीन क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. सो थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल मीट टुमोरो अगेन विथ अ न्यू टॉपिक. थैंक यू.